Hello, good morning.
大家早。
It's nice to be back here again.
能够回到我们当中，实在是很美好的事。
Yeah, the drive seems a little bit long.
我是需要开远一点点的车。
But I kind of used to it already.
但是我好像已经习惯了。
Every time I go to Eddy Farm, it's kind of like taking that long.
每次我去那个农场的时候，也都是要开很久的。
But the ride here, even though a little bit cookie.It's good.
虽然开到这里路有一点点弯弯曲曲，但是还是很好的。
So, may peace be with you.
愿神的平安与大家同在。
Well, today, we're going to look at a little story in Genesis.
今天我们将要来看创世纪里面的一个小故事。
Genesis has two pictures.
在创世纪里有两个图画。
One picture, one big picture, one small picture.
一个是一个大的图画，一个是一个小图画。
Definitely, the book of Genesis opens with a huge, big, gigantic picture.
很自然的，我们可以看见，在创世纪一开始是有一幅很大很大的图画。
God created the world.
神创造了诸世界。
God created man and woman.
神创造了人和女人。
So that was a big.Gigantic picture.
所以我们看到一个巨幅。
And yet,
然而
in Genesis, you also see a very small picture.
在创世纪里，你也看到小小的图画。
It talks about little things about life.
讲到生命中的一些小事情。
When we read Genesis,
当我们读创世纪的时候
in many ways, it's kind of like a mirror we are looking at about ourselves.
从很多角度来看，我们好像在对着镜子看我们自己。
Love and hope，
爱和盼望。
Difficulty，
困难。
Relationship，
人际关系。
Good relationship，
好的关系。
Close relationship，
亲密的关系。
But also difficult relationship，
还有困难的关系。
And so when we put these two pictures together。
当我们把这两幅图画放在一起的时候
，we can understand, we can see our life through these two pictures.
我们就可以透过这两幅图画来看见我们自己的生活。
Then we can see how great God is.
我们就可以看到我们的神有多伟大。
Yes, of course, God is great.
当然，神他很伟大。
But His love is great to us.
但是他的爱对我们更是伟大。
In today's passage.
在今天的经文中
It talks about Jacob brought his family down to Egypt.
讲到雅各带着全家下到埃及去
Actually, what's the reason that he went down to Egypt?
那他下埃及的原因是什么呢
Well, because they were in famine.
因为他们处在饥荒中
The story really started with a huge problem.
这个故事是从一个很大的困难开始的。
Jacob was rich.
雅各他本身很富有。
He has plenty of things.
他有很多东西。
And yet, when a famine came,
但是当饥荒来到的时候
，no people rich enough to take care of a famine.
没有一个人是富足到能够去面对饥荒。
That is the story behind that.
这就是背后的故事。
Then, of course, the main reason why Jacob was willing to go down to Egypt.
而雅各之所以愿意下到埃及的主要原因是
It was that his son told him.
因为他的儿子告诉他
Jacob is in Egypt. Jacob. No, not Jacob.
Joseph.
Joseph.
约瑟在埃及。
Joseph was in Egypt.
约瑟在埃及。
Can you imagine?
你可以想象吗?
You know, at the time when Judah come before him.
当犹大来到约瑟面前的时候
He said, Father.
犹大来到雅各面前的时候他说
Joseph,
父亲
Joseph was in Egypt.
他对他的父亲说约瑟在埃及
He wants you to go down with me.
他希望你跟我一起下埃及
To see him.
去见他
我们中国人说如梦初醒，对不对 ？It's just like a dream.
如梦初醒。
啊。 But he was kind of like worrying.
但是雅各心里有一些担忧。
This is the passage we were reading.
这就是我们今天所读的经文。
Because God appeared to him.
但是神向他显现。
And told him that don't worry.
告诉他不要担忧。
Well, it meant that he must have been worried a lot.
因此我们可以知道他在之前一定是很忧虑的。
Right? Otherwise, you know, it doesn't need God to come to tell you, hey, don't worry.
他若之前不是那么的忧虑，神不需要来到他的面前对他说，你不需要担忧。
Well, the Bible did not really tell us that what he was worrying about.
当然圣经里面并没有告诉我们雅各在担忧什么。
But in our own experience.
但是在我的经验里，
we sort of feel his worry.
我们可能可以感受到他的忧虑。
Because he need to uproot himself.
因为他必须要连根拔除他自己。
He has been doing that once.
他以前做过这么一次事。
Right? When he was young,
当他年轻的时候，
he need to flee from his home.
他必须要从他的家逃走。
But then, that wasn't a good experience.
但是那对他并不是一个好的经历。
Because when he get to his uncle,
因为当他到了他舅舅那里，
the relationship became very complicated.
他跟人的关系变得非常的复杂。
It's supposed to be a very sweet and warm relationship.
本来应该是很美好、很亲密的一个关系。
And yet there was a lot of deception between both of them.
但是在雅各跟他舅舅当中却有很多分歧。
And when he left with fear too.
而当雅各离开他舅舅的时候，他是带着惧怕逃走的。
Yeah, he did not even tell his uncle, "I'm going home."
他甚至在离开之前，并没有告诉他的舅舅说他要离开。
Because he has fear.
因为他心中有惧怕。
Of course, he has another fear.
当然，他有另外一个惧怕。
A fear to see who? His brother, right?
他害怕见他自己的哥哥。
And Joseph was not Joseph. Jacob was a smart guy.
但是雅各是一个非常聪明的人。
Everything that he wants, he got it.
他只要想要东西，他一定可以得到。
No matter how difficult it was,
那件事情是多困难。
He was able to outthink everybody.
他能够想的比每个人都还深。
And yet his life was full of fear.
因为他的生命里面充满惧怕。
Uprooted is not easy.
连根拔除的事并不是容易的。
I think we all have some sort of experience about this.
我们可能都有这方面的一些类似经历。
But for us, because we believe we are going for a better place.
但是对我们来说，我们都相信我们去的地方是一个更好的地方。
We are looking for a greater dream.
我们是在寻求更好的、更大的梦。
So when we first arrive here,
所以当我们刚开始来到美国的时候，
Yes, we were uprooted.
是的，我们是从我们原来地方连根拔除的。
But we have a future to look forward to.
未来的。
So we fight.
所以我们就征战。
We work hard.
我们很努力。
How hard?
多努力呢？
You know.
你们都知道。
You know better than me.
你们都比我更清楚。
Because all of us here have that experience.
因为我们所有的人在这里都有一样的经历。
But like Joseph.Not Jacob.
但是对雅各来说，
he doesn't have a future to uproot himself.
当他连根拔除自己的时候，他其实并没有一个未来他可以看得见的。
And he was so afraid.
他心中是充满恐惧。
To live under somebody.
活在某人的阴影之下。
But he has one reason.
但是他有一个理由。
He finally decided to leave.
他最后决定要离开。
It was Joseph.
就是因为约瑟的原因。
So the previous passage.
在之前的经文里。
He said.
他说。
Let me still have time so that I can go down to see my son, Joseph.
让我还在我还有年日的时候，我可以下去见我的儿子约瑟。
That's the reason why.He brought his whole family down to Egypt.
这就是他为什么带他的全家下到埃及去的原因。
This is a small picture.
这是一个小小的图画。
Right? It's about a family.
是吗？就是关于一个家庭而已。
It's about one man.
是关于一个人的故事。
But actually, behind this small picture,
但是在这个图画的背面
，there was a big picture.
还有一个大的图画。
We find a big picture in Genesis 15, I believe, if I remember correctly. Number, sometime I got mixed up.
我们在创世纪十五章里可以看到这个大图画。
God appeared to Abraham the third time.
神第三次向亚伯拉罕显现。
And then after he renewed, revealed, reinstated the promise to Abraham.
当神向对亚伯拉罕重新立约，重新应许他。
Then he told Abraham one thing.
他告诉亚伯拉罕一件事。
He said, "Your descendant will be going to another place, and then they will be persecuted."
他对亚伯拉罕说，你的后裔将要去到另外一个地方，而那地方的人要逼迫他们。
For 400 years.
长400年之久。
Then I will bring them out.
然而我会带他们离开。
I will punish that place, that nation.
我会刑罚那逼迫他们的国家。
I think at that time, you know, if you hear something like this,
我想在那个时候，如果你听到这样子的话，
you will scratch your head.
你可能会抓着脑勺。
You don't understand.
你不明白。
But actually, this is the background of today's little story.
而这个神跟亚伯拉罕的对话，就是我们今天这个小故事的背景。
For Jacob, it was a decision.
对雅各来说，这是一个决定。
A decision to overcome his fear.
一个克服他心中恐惧的一个决定。
But behind this,
但在这背后，
there was God's plan and God's will.
这里面是有神的计划和神的心意。
The whole thing was God's guidance.
整件事情都是神的引导。
Without man's permission.
没有神允许。
Without man's understanding.
没有我们的认识。
Right? If we know this is God's will Jacob, will the people permit?
如果没有神显明的话，人能够明白吗？
So we don't.
我们不明白。
And yet,
然而，
that was true.
这是事实。
We all live according to the will of God.
其实我们都活在神的心意之中。
Yes, the will of God relating to our daily living.
而神的旨意带着我们度过每一天。
Relate to the years that when we are on earth.
我们在世的日子。
But also,It was because he has a big, gigantic plan.
除了我们在世的日子，我们经历神的旨意以外，神他自己还有一个巨大的心意。
And here we see that God appeared to Jacob.
这里我们看见神向雅各显现。
He encouraged him.
神鼓励雅各。
Sometime when we're in the will of God, the thing that we are facing.It's not easy.
有时候，虽然我们活在神的旨意之下，但是我们所面对的事情对我们来说并不容易的。
Just by listening to the corporate prayer.
就像我们今天听到主席带我们的祷告。
Even in the prayer, there were stories.
就在今天的祷告里面都有一些故事的。
Yeah, I learned about Diane's situation.
我听到 Diane 她的情况。
When I was driving here,
我开车来到这当中的路上。
I was asking myself, will I see her today?
我自己心里在问，我今天会在这里看到 Diane 吗？
Then I guess probably not.
那我心里想，大概不会。
Because I know she would be in the hospital.
因为我知道她一定是在医院里。
Yeah, and then in prayer, mentioning.They must be very tired.
而在祷告里面也提到，他们最近一定是很疲倦的。
Yes.
是的。
Yeah, went through a story like this.
我们都常常会经历类似这样的故事。
But I'm also sure.
但是我也很确定。
God showed up to her.
我确定神向他显现。
And for her.
也为他显现。
We probably expect not, we don't know exact outcome at this point yet.
在这个时刻，我们可能还不知道结果将是如何。
Just like on the day when my wife was in the hospital.
就像有一次我的太太在医院里。
I went to the hospital. It was as usual because she went to the hospital just like go for vacation.
我就像一般的情况去医院，因为我的太太时常跑医院的。
So that day the doctor told us that she needed a surgery.
但是那一天我去医院的时候，医生告诉我我的太太需要一个手术。
And then I asked him, what's the possibility?
我问他这个手术的几率是怎么样。
He said 50-50.
医生说五十跟五十。
But she also said, the doctor also said, if she doesn't take the surgery, that would be the end of it.
但是医生也说，如果你的太太不动这个手术，那她的生命可能就到此为止。
No matter what，
不管如何。
At that time, it was not about your brain, but it's all about your heart.
在那个时候，关键就不是在你的头脑，而是在你的心。
Your brain may try to analyze, but actually your heart is full of fear and uncertainty.
你的头脑可能不断在分析情况，但是你的心里面充满的是不安定跟恐惧。
I don't know how to make the decision.
我不知道如何做决定。
There were three possibilities.
有三个可能性。
One, go in and then come out just like before.
有一个可能性就是他动了手术出来还是一样。
One, she goes in and then no return.
第二个可能他进了手术室就不再出来。
Or she return and then have a really big fight with herself.
或是他动了手术出来以后，还有面对很大很大的困难。
Very difficult.
非常难做决定。
But then, I think God helped me.
但是我想神在那个时候帮助了我。
She said, "Why don't you take any outcome? It's the best outcome."
神对我说，为什么你不去看所有的结果都会是最好的结果呢
？Yeah, then I think, okay.Every outcome is the best outcome.
那我就想，是的，每一个结果都会是最好的结果。
Then I find peace.
因为这样的思想就带领我有平安。
And then I find strength.
然后我就得到力量。
Then my wife did come out from the surgery.
而我的太太也真的是顺利的从手术里面出来。
I think afterward,
在那之后
she has to fight about, I forgot, 15 or 17 days.
在那个手术之后，他还是有十五到十七天的困难时间。
But during that time, it was very difficult.
在那段时间是很困难的。
But God constantly gave me something.
但神一直给我一些意念。
Some thought.
一些想法。
The thought gave me strength.
这些思想意念给我力量。
I still remember at the on the day that we decide, you know, to let go.
我还记得那一天我们决定要放下一切。
So we agreed to the doctor that we don't use any medication anymore.
所以我们跟医生说，我们决定不再使用任何的医药治疗。
So it means that will be the night.She will pass away unless God do something.
那表示那个晚上，我的太太可能就这样子过去了。如果神都没有做任何事的话。
And then it was about 1 a.m. We made the decision about 8:30, so it was about 1 a.m. afternoon.
我们在那一个晚上的八点半做了这样一个决定，到了清晨一点多的时候。
So actually, my daughter broke down.
我的女儿在那个时候已经崩溃了。
She said, "I cannot let go. I cannot let go."
我的女儿说：“我放不下，我放不下。
”I don't know what to do.
我也不知道怎么做。
But then, all of a sudden, a realization came to me.
但是突然，我明了到一件事情。
All of a sudden, I realized that in this situation, there must be pain.
突然我领悟到在这样的情况里面是一定有痛苦的。
The question is not you can have pain or not. The question is who would bear the pain?
那个时候的问题不是说你会不会有痛苦，而是是谁来承担承受这个痛苦。
For us, you know, we feel very painful.
对我们来说，我们处在一个非常痛苦状态中。
My daughter was in pain.
我的女儿心里很痛苦。
She doesn't want to lose her mother.
因为她不想失去她的母亲。
But then I realized that if we feel better than my wife, then her mother has to bear the pain.
但是我就想到说，如果要让我们心里好受的话，那我的太太她自己就要承受她身体上面的痛苦。
In the whole 17 days,
在整个十七天当中
，actually, was under heavy medication.
在那十七天当中，她都使用很重很重的药物。
Kind of like semi-unconscious.
而也她也一直处在半昏迷状态。
But in a little struggle.
站在这挣扎当中
，You know that must be very painful for her.
对她来说也是很痛苦的。
Because she, my wife can take pain very severely.
我太太是可以承受很痛苦事情的人。
But you see that little gesture, and then you know she was struggling.
但是从她身体的一些肢体动作，你可以知道说她是处在一个挣扎、非常痛苦的状态中。
So at least that helped me to let go.
因为这样的认知，就帮助我能够放得下。
So I share with my daughter.
我就跟我女儿分享。
I don't know exactly how she, you know, took it at that time.
我不知道我女儿在那个时候她的能够领受多少。
But there, a different thought came to me.
但是在我的脑海里有许多的思想。
They kind of like carrying me through.
这些意念就带着我度过这些事情。
Jacob was in a very difficult situation. Very has a great fear.
雅各在这个时候也是带着极大的惧怕，在面对一个困难的情形。
But God appeared to him.
但神向他显现。
Speak to him.
对他说话。
I think we probably have this experience.
我想我们可能也有类似的经历。
If you think back your life.
如果你回想你过去的生命里。
There must be some incident that difficult for you.
一定有发生过一些对你来说是困难的事件。
And yet God spoke.
而那个时候神向你说话。
When God speaks.
当神说话的时候。
And we are willing to open our heart.
而我们也愿意打开我们的心。
To take what He said.
来领受神对我们所说的话。
Then we will find peace. We will find strength.
我们就可以因此而找到平安，而得到力量。
Yes.
是的。
Yeah, in that experience, I experienced that. In experiencing my wife passing away, I experienced that.
在我太太过世的那件事情上面，我经历的这样的一个感受。
But actually, God really comforted.
而事实上，神真的是安慰了雅各。
Actually, in Jacob's whole life.
在雅各的一生中。
What was the biggest loss?
他最大的损失是什么？
It's the loss of his son, right?
他最大的损失就是他失去他最爱的儿子。
He loved this son.
他非常爱这个孩子。
He favored, taught him.
这是他最爱的儿子。
And then actually because of that,
也因为是如此。
It caused the jealousy of the brothers.
造成了其他的弟兄对他这个儿子的嫉妒。
That was his ignorance.
那是他自己的无知。
Whatever.
那不论如何。
He lost his son.
他失去了他的儿子。
For many, many years.
非常非常多年。
And then, you know, when you read down the passage.
如果你继续看往下的经文。
Then you will see when Jacob and Joseph met.
你会看到当雅各跟约瑟相见的时候。
Jacob said.
雅各说。
Today, if I die,
今天如果我就是今天死了
English, I don't remember how. 甘心啊，就是 willing. Yeah, even I die, I will be willing because I see you today.
他对约瑟说，因为我今天见了你，我就是今天死，我都甘心了。
So that must be his comfort.
所以他心里必定得到极大的安慰。
I don't know. You know, throughout all this year, every time when he thought of Joseph,
在这么多年过去了，当他见到约瑟的时候
，I would think every time when he thought of Joseph, a thought would came to him.
我在想他失去约瑟的那些年中，每次他想到约瑟的时候，他就有这样的意念。
I shouldn't have sent Joseph to look for his brother on that day.
我当年那一天实在不应该差约瑟去找他的哥哥们。
Right.
是不是
that was the every time when he thought of Joseph, he will think back.
每次当他想到约瑟的时候，他就会想到那件事情。
This is what I should have not done.
这是我那一天不应该做的事。
Regret.
后悔。
Regret, regret, regret.
后悔，后悔，后悔。
Feeling sad, feeling sad.
难过，难过，难过。
So that was his life.
这就是他的生活。
But now,
但是现在
he see Joseph.
他见到约瑟了。
He got comfort.
他得到安慰了。
But actually, Jacob don't understand the reason why Joseph was there because it was fulfilling God's big plan, right?
而事实上，这么多年来，雅各都不知道。约瑟之所以会在埃及，是因为神的一个最大的计划。
That's how great is God's love for us.
这就是神对我们的爱是何等的大。
Usually we look for significant, we look for meaning.
很多时候我们都在寻找意义、重要的事。
We all want ourselves to be some great person.
我们都希望我们自己能够成为一个。有地位的人。
If we could, we would really like ourselves to be great.
如果可以的话，我们都很希望我们自己能够成为伟大的人。
If I'm a scientist,
如果我是一个科学家。
If I am good enough, I really want myself to be a great scientist, right?
如果我够有能力的话，我都希望我自己能够成为有名、很伟大的科学家。
But think about this.
但是想想
，this whole thing，
整件事情
，is relating to the big plan of God，
都是跟神最大的计划有关系的。
Sometimes, you know, our experience is so small.
很多时候我们所经历的是这样小的事
，so insignificant，
这么不重要。
Oftentimes, so painful too.
有些时候也是痛苦的。
But let us understand.
但是让我们能够明白。
We belong to a small picture within a big picture.
我们是在一个小的图画里，而这个小的图画里是在一个大图画里面的。
And it was arranged by God.
而这是神安排的。
I think that's what the Job story told us.
我想约瑟的故事告诉我们。
Job believed the God that who really, you know, have the right.Over his life.
我们讲的是约伯的故事，而约伯他相信神的主权是在他的生命里的。
Yeah, if you give me, this is according to your will.
如果你所给我的是按着你的旨意来的。
If you take away, it is also because of your will.
而当你收取的时候，这个也是你的心意。
And that was the basic belief that helped.Job to cross the problem.
也因着这样子的信心跟信仰，帮助了约伯能够度过他所有的困难。
So in this picture, right, in this story,
在这个故事里
，it reminds us
提醒了我们
who we are.
我们是谁
？We're very little.
我们是很渺小的。
And yet, we don't know. We may be in some way in a big picture that we are very significant.
而当我们不知道的时候，其实很多时候我们是在一个大的图画里是有重要的地位的。
So this passage continued. It mentioned Jacob brought about 70 people down to Egypt.
所以今天的信息再继续读的话，我们看到雅各带了他全家70人下埃及。
But then, when the Israelite people left, how many of them?
而当以色列人离开埃及的时候，你们知道有多少人吗？
It's a million.
是几百万的。
He lived in Egypt was a good place.
他们住在埃及是一个好的地方吗？
But then, after they left,
而当他们离开的时候，
they entered the promised land.
当他们离开之后，他们是进入应许之地。
Of course, it's not an easy thing.
当然，这过程并不是很简单的。
You have to fight.
你必须要征战。
There were struggle.
也有一些挣扎。
There were challenges.
有一些挑战。
But then they are the people of God.
然而他们是神的子民。
Yeah. In our life, we were like this.
我们的生命也是像这样子。
There are a lot of ups and downs.
有高有低。
But we remember.
但是我们要记得。
We are people of God.
我们是神的子民。
Not only that.
不单单如此，
we are children of God.
我们是神的儿女。
The emphasis is not on children, but the emphasis should be on God.
重点不是儿女，重点是神。
Who are you?
你是谁？
I am Yip Yik Ming's son. Who's Yip Yik Ming? Nobody. Nobody knows who my father is.
我是叶启明的儿子，但是叶启明是谁？没有人知道叶启明的父亲是谁。
I don't even know my grandfather's name.
我甚至不知道我祖父的名字。
Yeah, it's insignificant.
我是这样的渺小。
But what gave us the significance?
但是我们之所以能够有一个重要性
is that we are children of God.
是因为我们是神的儿女。
Okay, who you think you are?
所以你认为你是谁呢？
But remember.
要记得
This God is not like Wang Dai Xin.
这个神并不是黄大仙。
In Hong Kong, it's Wang Dai Xin, 有求必应。你要什么就得到什么。
在香港，黄大仙是有求必应。
But this God is not like that.
但是这位神并不是那样的神。
This God is a personal God.
这个神是一个个人的神。
I became a Christian when I was 15.
我十五岁的时候成为基督徒。
And I don't know how the people believe in Wang Dai Xin when they go through the difficulty like us. How would Wang Dai Xin come for them?
我不知道那些相信黄大仙的人，他们怎么样去面对困难，然后他们相信的那个黄大仙怎样帮助他们度过他们的困难。
I would think.That's very different.
我常常觉得很不可思议。
Yeah. So let us remember this.
让我们记得。
Who we are.
我们是谁。
And yes, we live in a very small picture.
是的，我们是活在一个小的图画里
面。Just daily living.
就是每一天的平静的生活。
We struggle with our health. We struggle with relationship. We struggle with our children.
但在我们生活里面，我们可能因着我们的身体健康，跟人的关系，跟我们的儿女有一些挣扎的事情。
We struggle at a workplace.
我们在工作中可能也有一些困难的事。
But all this.
但是这一切。
Actually, it happened within a big, gigantic picture of God.
这一切的事情都是发生在神所计划的一个大图画里面。
And God would visit us.
而神会来看望我，
Just like he visited Jacob.
就好像他看望雅各一样。
Just like he visited Joseph.
就好像他看望约瑟一样。
Yes, I think in the first song we sang, second song we sang.
我想今天我们所唱诗的第二首里面。
He said, "In when we are thirst, we are longing for God."
在第二首诗歌里面讲到说，当我们口渴，我们心里有渴望的时候，我们是渴望神。
在 in the desert, We seek God.
在旷野中我们寻求神。
When I sing it, all of a sudden, I realize.
当我今天早上在唱那首诗歌的时候，我突然领悟到。
I mean, when we are thirst, 在干地，哪里说的是？ The dry land, right? The dry land, you know, what's in our mind?
我们在干地干渴的时候，我们想的是什么呢？
When they kind of like in a desert, there's nobody.Desert is nobody there.
当我们在旷野的时候，那是一个无人之地。
And then you start looking.
你就四处瞻望。
Looking for whom?
你想要寻找谁呢？
Looking for God.
你要寻求神。
And it was in that situation that.
就是在那样的一个情况中，我们会做这样的事。
We meet God.
我们遇见神。
Or actually, it was in that situation that God come to us and.Meeting us.
或是我们应该说是在那个时候神他就自己来遇见我们。
Let us come together.
让我们聚在一起。
To pray for each other.
彼此代祷。
To believe for each other.
也为彼此来相信一件事。
It means we believe God for them when they pray.
就是我们为我们所祷告的人相信神。
Yeah, that he's a great God.
因为他是一位伟大的神。
And yet he cares about us.
但是他却顾念我们每一个人。
Yeah, he look after us.
他看顾我们。
Let's pray.
让我们一起祷告。
Dear my Father.
亲爱的天父。
Thank you, thank you, thank you so much.
谢谢你，谢谢你，非常的谢谢你。
Yes, it was very true.
事实上是这样子。
When we are in a difficult situation, when we are desperate,
当我们在一个困难的情况中，当我们觉得无望的时候，
even when we feel hopeless, helpless,
完全失去盼望，完全无助的时候，
but you came at this moment always.
而你永远在那样的时刻来到我们面前。
Yeah, let us every time when we feel difficult.
是的，每一次当我们感到困难的时候。
Let us turn back to our life.
让我们愿意来回想我们的生命。
To the moment that you have visited us.
让我们回想你曾经来看望我们。
Father God, thank you so much.
亲爱的天父，谢谢你。
You are so great.
你是如此的伟大。
And yet, you care about us.
然而，你却顾念我们。
We do pray for Diane and her family and her daughter.
我们现在真是要为 Diane 还有她的家庭跟她的女儿来祷告。
We pray that the Holy Spirit will pray for them.
我们祷告，圣灵也为他们祷告。
Because the Holy Spirit knows what's the Father's will.
因为圣灵知道神的心意。
So dear God,
亲爱的神,
may you listen to our prayer.
愿你垂听我们的祷告。
And Holy Spirit teach us how to pray.
圣灵也教导我们如何祷告。
Let us to show love for each other at this moment.
让我们在有需要的时候，我们能够对弟兄姐妹来显出我们的爱。
Dear God, thank you.
亲爱的神，谢谢你。
Thank you.
谢谢你听我们祷告。
Yeah. Amen.
Amen.